Hi friends, just in my front room here. I'm out, can't get it all in. This is somebody was expressing concern about this yesterday, that they didn't like it, made them feel a bit funny, but it shouldn't do really, because it's just a symbolisation of the seven chakras. So you got the root chakra, the sacral chakra, well, the root chakra is at the base of your spine. The sacral chakra is just in your abdomen, below your belly button. Then you've got the solar plexus chakra, which is above your belly button, just under your rib cage, the bottom of your rib cage, in the sort of hollow. And then you've got the green heart chakra. And then you've got blue throat chakra. These are the Sanskrit symbols on them as well, so they're all lotuses as well. So that's the brow chakra, your inner eye. And then you've got the symbolism, the not chakra. You've got the symbolism of the yin and yang, and that's just to show the balance of all natures and forces that you've got opposing to each other. But they come out in balance. And then you got this bit, which I think was the bit that probably creeped her out. That's your crown chakra, and it's just showing spiritual flames coming out of it, because that's what it does. It comes out above your head, and it's the spiritual connection. So your inner eye, your power of speech, and your throat chakra, emotional center, your heart chakra. And then you've got the solar plexus chakra, very intuitive chakra. And then you've got your spleen chakra, or sacral chakra, in your abdomen. That's your sexual and reproductive chakra. And then the root chakra. Now you've got a serpent, a dragon. And that's symbolising what comes from the root chakra. And it's the Kundalini, which is a power that can be conjured up from the root chakra, and it comes shooting up your spine through all the chakra up into your mind and crown chakra. It's not recommended trying the Kundalini, to raise the Kundalini, unless you're very experienced at it, because it can be very overpowering. So yeah, these are in all living things, all animals, all people. We all have the chakra system. The chakras provide our daily energy requirements for our spirit and our life being. So they're energy centers, but they're also perception centers through which we perceive different things. So you perceive more spiritual things through the crown, and you just see things, more spiritual, intuitive things in the inner eye. Your throat chakra, spirit can actually talk through you through the throat chakra. The heart chakra, you get the emotions and feelings and different things of others. Your intuitive psychic gut feelings in your solar plexus chakra, so instinctual gut feelings that you should take notice of. And then you've got your sexual reproductive chakra, and your root chakra is really your physical connection in the base of your spine, helps you connect with the physical realm. So that's what they are, and that's what they do. So nothing to fear about that. Absolutely harmless, and everybody's got them anyway. So yeah, anyway, that'll do for today. I'll show you around a bit more another time.